G'day legends, welcome to the DIY Video for Professionals podcast where we unravel the secrets behind crafting videos that screen professional without the hassle. I'm your host Chris Schwager, the DIY Maestro, here to guide you through the mesmerizing world of DIY video production. We take you beyond the lens, from the latest in DIY video, optimizing your tech setup, and even to candid chats with clients sharing personal stories that transcend the realm of video. This is your all-access pass to mastering the video game and living a life filled with action and decisions. Get ready to transform not just your videos, but your approach to life one episode at a time. Welcome to DIY Video for Professionals. This is only a So Greg Gladman joins us today. He's a client who has come on board recently from a great deal that we put on last year. Originally was struggling to see the full potential of what having a system like this would bring to his business. And after looking at one of his clients and our clients, Jason Howes, he was able to actually see and acknowledge that there was a full, a lot more room to be had with regards to having a kind of a one button switch right at your desk in your home. And welcome aboard.
Thanks, Chris. Thanks for inviting me along today. It certainly has been a game changer for us.
Yeah, man. And this is how we roll, right? Like, we like to interview our clients because we share similar things. We're all small business owners, and most of the time we have a lot of stories around either parenting or business or video that we can share with one another. And it's a great way to document video rather than constantly looking for video creation. Video creation can take lots of time, as you and I both know. And so where clients have benefited from recording in this way allows me to just go and share the video files with them, and then they pick it up at their end and they maybe give it to their edit team, and they go off and cut some little highlights out of it as well, and then they share it with us and we share it with them. And it's kind of a nice way to increase visibility for all parties. And you seem like a nice bloke and a very knowledgeable bloke as well, and hence why I have you on the show today. So Greg, tell me about, first of all, I'll go down the case study route, I guess. You had your usage for video where you thought, you know, video was going to play a role in your business at the time. For our audience, take them through a little bit about your business and I guess where you were pre-DIY video studio.
For sure, yeah. So look, Chris, we run a sales training and coaching business, not too dissimilar to Jason. I actually work closely with Jason, so that's how we got to meet you. I would say, I always make a bit of a joke that we were ahead of the COVID curve. We had set up our business, so from about 2018, that we do some intensive face-to-face work, and everything after that, myself and our coaches are on video. So the fortnightly coaching of sales team and sales managers, even quarterly reviews, all were done via video. And as you would have seen from our first phone conversation, that was done very poorly from a computer, Surface Pro camera on top of a computer, and was very, you know, grainy and pixelated and looks terrible, but I didn't really know any better. And so starting to have some chats with Jason and seeing the screen and seeing how well he presented and how poorly I looked, that sort of prompted me to reach out and have a chat. Now, when we first spoke, when you said that, hey, you thought I was a lost cause, I probably wasn't thinking about the potential of what else we could do with it. I was more thinking about, you know, do I really need to have a better quality video just to do coaching? But we started to have a look at different ways that we could utilize video. Jason was kind enough to share what he was doing and some of the stuff that how he was utilizing it. And I went into his studio, had a play around, loved it. And then coincided with your sale that you had on at the time, and the rest is history. So we were using very low quality, grainy, pixelated laptop images.
What is it about video, I guess, in this way, that has sort of drawn you closer to investing? I mean, it's not just a little pissy amount, right? It's a decent investment. What was the penny drop moment for you?
Look, I think one day when I was having a catch up with Jason, he was using his DIY studio, and I was just on my laptop and just looking at his picture quality versus mine. And if we have a look at the, how long I'm sitting in front of a computer and a camera, you know, every day, it would be a minimum of 4 hours up to 8 hours a day, sometimes longer, where we're doing, you know, strategy sessions, coaching, sales calls. And I just thought, well, you know, if I'm spending so much time in front of the computer and in front of a camera, it just seems silly to have a little crappy one that's sort of linked to the top of a laptop. So that was probably the catalyst. Look, also what we've found is that more and more of our little short videos and content creation was being done, again, via poor quality cameras. So it just sort of was the right timing, and you know, obviously seeing Jason using it, and then your little Christmas promo that you did was just enough to get it across the line and say, yeah, let's just do it.
How much of it is like you charge thousands of dollars? We had a client of ours, financial planner, report back and say, look, he just wasn't comfortable, you know, doing deals thousands of dollars at a time with his clients and showing up on a crap webcam, and it was all kind of spawning from the early sort of 2020, you know, everyone's doing poor quality. So it's, you know, let's call it video pandemic, right? It was just a lot of crap. And so it was an ability in some regard to differentiate. What was it for you, I guess? What was it that feeling like, you know, got to sort of improve? Because that certainly, if I recollect back to say 2018-19, where we went all in on sales via Zoom, which was pre-2020, right? Which meant not a lot of people were using it. We had to sort of educate them on how they could do this, right? But we weren't moving because we were just sick of traveling everywhere. And then for us, it was like, oh shit, we're a video company. Is this it? Is this what we're projecting in the first impression of our call? You know, so I guess, again, back to the point, you know, it's a decent investment. Where are you drawing the line and saying, no, I need to show up better?
Look, I think I probably wasn't even aware that it was a problem until I started to see someone else using it.
Right.
And look at the quality of the video. And, you know, if I look at the hourly rates that clients are paying for our executive coaching or consulting, and you know, and how the videos were turning out. We started also to get a lot of clients wanting to record the videos that we were doing with them to show to, you know, to put in a library and to be able to show to new salespeople joining the team down the track, so that they weren't having to try to remember my version of the event and or the situation and then try to repeat it. They can just literally pull the video up and show it. So I think, you know, there was a number of different factors that came into play. But I think just, you know, having a better quality presentation was one. I think customers wanting to record and keep some of this stuff on file was another. And I think the third one too was that we started playing around with a software called Vidyard, where we're actually just doing some, you know, sort of even doing presentations of proposals. So, you know, sometimes we might be presenting to a CEO who can give a verbal sign off subject to board approval. And what we found is that, guess what? The CEO is not going to sell us and our service offering as well as we can, but we had no way of getting in front of the board. So again, if we've got the ability to use this great piece of software to be able to do a virtual walkthrough of a proposal and shoot it off, I wanted to make sure that if my face is in front of a board making a decision on are we going to invest, you know, 40, 50, 60, 100 grand with this company, that my, you know, visual presentation's coming off to be, you know, spot on.
It's just such a great tool, right? Like I had a conversation with somebody this morning around video coaching. I sort of got to the point where I understood more about the opportunity, and he was sold. He said, I've scoured your site. I know what you're capable of. I know how good it all is. I just need to convince my boss to spend a little bit of money on making this happen, and I get a bit of benefit out of it because I get the training and everything. And I was like, you know what? Why don't I just give you the proposal with the price, and I'll record a little 4 or 5 minute video for you, and I'll explain to them why it is that you're going to invest in this. And he's like, oh, would you? That'd be awesome. That'd be so great, right? And just that that ease. I mean, I would go in completely unrehearsed, go in with the intent that my primary, you know, objective is to build, have them build confidence with a complete stranger, I guess, you know, in 5 minutes, a shorter period of time, and you know, correlating the benefits of why, you know, this is going to be a great investment for them. But the primary thing here is, like, he openly admitted, I would need a lot of effort and not a lot of work and preparation to try and pitch this to them. So, well, don't bother. Just send them the proposal with a video in it, and you're hearing it firsthand from me, right? And that's worked in many occasions for decent deals, for like $25,000, $30,000 deals as well. And I know firsthand that video has not only been presented to the decision maker, but has also been presented to the people involved in the project. So the first time we ever tried it, there was 10 others involved in the operational side of the project from their end, and they all got to see it. It's like, all right, pretty much the scope of works is included. So here it is. Here's the scope. Here's why you need it. Here's the guy that's going to present it and help you. And it was just like a very streamlined approach to closing a deal that could have probably been pretty long-winded and lots of back and forths and whatnot. So how do you find the ability to just get on and, I guess, go off the cuff like that? I'm finding, for me, it's now just a race against the clock. I've got to be able to spit this out with all of the inconsistencies and all of the, you know, little human errors that I fucking a human, right? Big whoop. I'm starting to drop my guard a lot and let those roll with it all in the interest of time and not getting too bogged down in the process. How have you found it?
Well, if I rewind, you know, 2 years ago, if we wanted to record a video on a topic, that would be, you know, anywhere between a $4,000 to $6,000 investment to get a day in a studio, and it was a race against the clock trying to get as many things filmed in the day as you can, and you're trying to get it all perfect and have everything all, you know, spot on. Whereas now I can just do a video at the click of a finger on any topic, on anything, and it's literally turn on the camera and it's good to go. So it's a lot more agile, you know, for me, that I'm not having to try and think of what are the 20 topics I want to talk about in a month's time and then start building everything out. And I think too, I've also learned just through from the work I've done with you, but just with, I suppose, getting the understanding that it doesn't matter if you say something wrong or do something that's not exactly right, because it just makes it more original. It's more, you know, being a bit vulnerable around, hey, I said a wrong word and I recovered from it, doesn't matter. You know, whereas I used to be a perfectionist around, oh, I said the wrong word, I have to start that whole 10-minute video again.
Yeah.
Whereas if I was presenting to that board myself, I probably would have had the same little whoops or comment or thing that was different. It doesn't matter. You know, it's looking at the big picture around, you know, do they feel comfortable with me? Do they feel confident I'm the right person? Do they feel that the solution is the right solution for them and their business? And, you know, if that's presented by me and I have the odd little slip up or I say something that's, you know, correct my phrasing, it's still going to be 10 times better than a CEO trying to present that for the first time after hearing me talk for 20 minutes.
The reason you're hearing this podcast so clearly is because we've incorporated this. If you're on our YouTube channel, go and have a look at the quality that comes out of what we call the desktop video studio, and allows professionals just like yourself an ability to have camera, sound, lights, teleprompter, all at a single switch of a button and all at the convenience of your desk. Let's have a listen to a couple of happy clients who are using this system.
Get people that come to my masterclasses, and the first thing they do is they go, wow, and they know I'm here to get good value.
It has saved me a day, a month. Yeah, I now use video more because it's just easier to do.
The equipment is just incredible. It's easy. You're ready to go. Being able to come in here, turn it on and look down the barrel is just so good.
I can take a little bit more time with the delivery because there is no setup. Coming across more professionally, got to have a look at it. You are getting massive value.
Oh my God, I'm like wishing that all these years I would have saved myself time. It's just so much better. It was such a great investment. I can shoot videos like that.
You can switch it on, do a really fast message within 2 minutes. Having the best tools has taken my business to the next level.
If you want more information on how you can do this for yourself, go to ridgefilms.com.au/DIY. I did a full reply to inquiry, and I'm loosening up my reply inquiries recently now, going from 30 seconds contrived 30 seconds to a much looser 1 minute. Like, hey, you know, really casual and trying to ease them in and use that, drop their name in and drop a lot of value in there and stuff at the same time. Anyway, I got through this. I got like 50 seconds through this video and the guy's name was Will. And I got to the end and I went, oh, thanks, Bill. And then I kind of went, oh, I fucked it. I got to go again. And I kept my composure, but I had a laugh and I kind of put my head down and then I pulled back out and went, sorry, Will, and just kept going and finished it. And then I got the meeting and I actually made a note of it and I said, oh, did you like the way I recovered? And he's like, I saw that you'd recovered from it. And it was a talking point. It was just like, it's completely human. And I think, I don't know if I was a startup or someone new to the game, maybe my perspective would be different. But because there's so much more skin in the game and maturity and the expertise is high, and I speak for you as well, I guess, you know, time is like so important now. It's like just making sure that you know what you're going to do and you get it off your desk as quickly as you possibly can. And if that means making a couple of little adjustments on the fly, so to speak, then
yeah.
Then, you know, what difference does it make? And I think that's one of the key things here is like, if I make this mistake for one video for one person, what difference does it make? Like, will it be better if I re-record it? Like, yeah, I mean, that's kind of where I'm at the moment, I think.
Definitely have learnt that just from, you know, some of the, I think one of the webinars I jumped on and one of the conversations I had with you is, you know, sometimes, you know, just having a bit more, you know, vulnerability or just leaving something in there doesn't do any harm. If anything, it just shows you're human and it's not a robotic response that's been pre-recorded and redone 15 times. It's raw, it's live, and it is what it is.
So you've had your kit for 4 months now, still working through applications and different ways you can use it. You've been traveling here, there and everywhere off overseas, recovering your business and whatnot. What are clients saying, I guess, with what you've shown them so far?
Yeah, so that's really interesting. So in the first, you know, because our clients, we're myself or one of the team is sort of, you know, coaching them usually fortnightly or monthly. And within the first month, every single client made a comment about, where are you? Are you in a studio? Are you in a... Like, that's not your... I said, it's the same office. I haven't moved. I'm in the same office. I just have better lighting and I don't have all the shadows and, you know, things coming in from outside. And I'm just set up, you know, well to be able to do these video conversations. And, you know, people... one person said he didn't believe me and he got me to take a video with my phone and send it to him. And so I showed him. I showed him what I've got. And he goes, oh, that's cool. But yeah, I've had comments all quite, you know, fun and jovial. But I had one CEO tell me that he watching me on the video, he feels less than. Right, that was his comment.
He feels less than.
And I said, less than what? And he goes, well, you look amazing, and I look terrible.
Yeah, so he's on the pedestal.
Yeah, yeah. So good. You know, it's all positive. And I think if people are actively making the comment around how amazing it looks, you know, just from doing a Zoom call or a Teams call, and you know, and most of these people who are making these comments have known me for years and have seen me in, you know, different, you know, webcam slash computer camera slash me on the fly traveling in hotels, and all of a sudden they just go, wow, what have you done? You know, that for me was a confirmation that I'd made the right decision.
It's kind of like the suit of the modern world now, isn't it? It's like you show up like dressed for the job that you want type of analogy, I guess. But it's kind of the same now. If you're showing up in good video and good audio, then you respect what you're sending out as in terms of visuals to the market. So you have a sense of pride, would you say? Sense of pride in your appearance. And I think with that, I guess, not to necessarily show people up, but it's just like, well, you can see the whites of my eyes clearer than you could ever see anybody else probably at this point. So do you think there's impact on like impression or what people like, what people think. I guess the real question I'm looking for here is, like, is it a case of the visuals have to match the thing that you bring, you know, the service that you provide? Like, if you were showing up great, looking amazing, but then had a shit service, it probably wouldn't matter, right? But because you're complementing an already great coaching business.
Yeah. Look, it's like, if we were budget basement and, dealing with the bottom end of town, I probably wouldn't have made this sort of investment. But the reality is that we're dealing with professional business people, CEOs, boards. We have sort of clients that are small family businesses right through to global giants. Like, our biggest client has over 10,000 salespeople scattered around the world. So, you know, when I'm hopping on a call with those guys, there might be 10 CEOs from all around the world, Germany, Asia, USA, Canada, Australia. So, you know, it's, you know, the audience is a fairly distinguished audience. So, you know, presenting well definitely helps my, you know, personal brand as well as the brand of the business. But the other thing that I haven't even mentioned yet is that as we're starting to build out more, you know, video content around some of the, you know, the basics around what we do, I now have the confidence that I can do a short 5-minute video or 10-minute video, upload it into an ecosystem and put it into our learning management system. So it means that I never actually have to redo that piece of work again. So enabling us to do some more systemization where, you know, instead of, I say, look, hey, before you jump on the call, watch this 10-minute video, so that we don't actually spend the first 10 minutes of the phone conversation talking about the theory around what we're going to be doing. We're just talking around, okay, you've done the theory. How do we bring that to life in your business? So it's also allowing me to be more effective with the time that I'm having with them. So it's less knowledge transfer and more bringing that to life in their business. So indirectly, it's going to give me more time to add value in the coaching call as opposed to talking through, there's certain principles around any topic that I say the same thing for the first 10 or 15 minutes of every call around that topic.
You got to ask yourself, are you satisfied with the way that you're presenting yourself and your personal brand to your market? And for 4 years now, people have been really struggling to clarify the way they look and sound on camera when it comes to doing video calls and recording their own personalized videos. And there is a solution. The DIY video program helps you personalize sales video and emails, record professional marketing videos, look and sound amazing in every video meeting without the tech hassles. And you also get professional video editing practical training so that you can present like a pro. You don't have to do anything in that initial setup because the studio is installed for you. You get your coaching and the training so that you can then go on and be a video professional and wipe out poor quality videos forever. Why don't you go to ridgefilms.com.au/DIY and check it out for yourself. It's so good, man. Like, that's such a strong piece that you gave, and I don't think people are really understanding the full capabilities of, you know, systematization. I mean, notoriously thought of as some kind of boring old document and drafting a bloody procedure manual and all that sort of bullshit. And that's not the modern systematization now. It's like, it's video content because it's record once and distribute forever, really. And, you know, we started doing that when we were onboarding our Filipino team, and it's like, man, what a difference it made to from the directive perspective of clearing your mind of that thing now. You know, with the right team, of course, you've got to have the right team that adapts quickly and understands and takes direction well. But the fact that I remember going, onboarding new people, going through, you know, the first couple of weeks and just recording so many videos, and they could have been 1 minute or they could have been 20 minutes, half an hour in some cases, and just going, boom, done, clear, send them the link, that's it. It's like, and then it was actually up to them to put it into its proper order. So not only were we actually getting the recordings done of the tasks that needed to be handled, but also then it was getting sorted properly for the next person. Mm. So such a great way to go. I mean, it's not exclusive to the desktop studio, but it certainly does help when you've got nice, clear.
Well, yeah. I think go back to your comment around the confidence. Like, when the quality of the video is high, you have no issues with directing someone to spend 10 minutes of their life to watch it, knowing that they're going to come away from that going, wow, that was really clear and concise. I could hear it well. I could see it well.
Yes.
Often there's a slide deck that might be going with that, and that's nice and crisp and clear.
Yes.
Yeah.
When it came to coaching and just a little bit of coaching that we've done so far, what's been the main thing that you've taken away from that?
I think there's probably a couple of things. One is, and this has been a constant battle with me whenever I have even done professional videography before, is that when you think you're over exaggerating, like expressions and emotions, you're not, and just putting a lot more energy and a smile into the conversation. That was probably just a really good reminder. And the other one I think is just is not being too phased if you say a wrong word or if you mumble something. I really found that I was a real perfectionist beforehand, but now having people seeing that you're a human being and that you make mistakes, it's not. And I'm not talking about like total wrong comments or things off the wall, but like just a little fumble or what you would do in a normal conversation, why wouldn't that go in a video to go to one client? Who cares?
Where to next, man? Where are you going? Like, what's the future for video and where do you see all this sort of,
Next step for us is that we're starting to really build out our learning management system. So all of our content is slowly being built out. It's happening a little slower than I would have liked just because we've been so busy coming into this end of financial year. I think we're starting to see some companies that have been sitting on the edge wanting to really, get into doing some, sales strategy and coaching to grow sales. So it's been a little slower than I'd hoped, but I'm still banging away and getting a few decent, quality videos going up into the platform every week. And the intention is to try to keep systematizing to be able to, give more value to our clients, but also have a library there that we can actually send people to, that if someone's got a quick question, rather than having to charge them for, a piece of time, I can actually just say, hey, look, do you want me to talk through that or can I just send you a video and off you go? And it makes my business a lot more scalable if I've got the ability to do that. And I think if I look back to, when we've done a short video takes in the past, it's probably a bit embarrassing. Like if you send them a really poor quality video, poor quality sound and say, hey, watch this. I think it's sort of not a very good, doesn't give a very professional, view of your business. Whereas now I don't have any hesitation with just recording a short little video, shooting it off. And if it's generic and it's not talking about anything that's industry specific or it's not specific to their business, I can then just save that up and up to the cloud.
Greg Gladman's business is Sales and Leadership Performance. He runs it out of Queensland, but he's worldwide, global, got plenty of staff and crew on board. And you should go definitely check out his business because he is really ripping it and looking and sounding like $1 million. And you can also check this out on our YouTube channel as well. Greg, I want to just say to you, thank you so much. This whole podcast, it appears, has been very centered around the desktop studio and the coaching and all the other stuff that we've been able to do. So I do appreciate you taking the time. I don't know how much value is here from a video, from a recording perspective to give to you for your own use, but I'm more than happy to do that. But as a case study for us to actually be able to use this across our marketing, it's a great resource. So I thank you very much for the last half hour that you've given me.
My pleasure. And I wouldn't be giving you my time today if I wasn't very comfortable for you to share this with any of your audience. And I'm very grateful that we came across each other's paths and were able to put this into play. So thank you as well.